Hey folks, Representative Derek Kilmer here. I want to start by saying thank you for being a part of this summit. In the midst of the most challenging health and economic situations our regions and our nation has dealt with in our lifetimes, all of you are continuing to show your dedication to our future. Your participation is a testament to how critical the Sound is to the economy and identity of our state. Everyone that has attended this summit, from small business owners and local electeds to environmental champions, has a reason that we care deeply about the recovery of Puget Sound and the ecosystem of life that it supports. For me, when I think about why the Sound is critical to our future, I think about my daughters and every kid in their generation. They represent the reason why this gathering has continued to grow each year, because we want to protect these treasures, the water, the salmon, the oysters, the orcas, everything, for the next generation and the generations after those. All of us are convinced that Puget Sound has no equal in terms of beauty and biological value, but we know that the Sound and other iconic bodies of fresh water in our country are in danger. As co-founder of the Puget Sound Recovery Caucus, along with my friend and roommate, Congressman Denny Heck, I've been working to prioritize the protection of the Sound. And I'm proud to share some exciting updates about what we've been able to accomplish. So, over the past few years, this administration has proposed zeroing out two critical programs, the Puget Sound Geographic Program and the National Estuary Program. These programs are vital to projects that improve water quality, enhance fish passage, increase salmon habitat, and protect shorelines. Now, not only have we been able to stop those cuts, we've actually received increased funding. I'm also excited to report that Congress took a major step forward to ensure the federal government lives up to its responsibility to help this magnificent body of water by passing the Puget SOS Act out of the House with bipartisan support. This bill will ensure that the federal government is the strong partner that state, tribal, and local entities need to save our Sound and assist regional efforts to restore salmon and orca populations and uphold tribal treaty rights. In addition, I believe we can and must do better to protect the Sound by preventing pollution from stormwater runoff and restoring critical habitat. Now, unfortunately, the American Society of Civil Engineers gave our nation a D+ when it comes to managing our stormwater. I would not let my daughters come home with that grade. It's unacceptable. We need to grow our investments in green infrastructure to help capture stormwater at its source before it becomes a pollution hazard. And that's why I introduced the Preventing Pollution Through Partnerships, or P3 Act. This bill would create a new category of private activity bonds to encourage private developers to use more sustainable technologies like green roofs and rain gardens and permeable pavement in their projects. That kind of development isn't just good for the Sound, it has huge benefits for local communities as well. It could truly be a win-win. I'm hopeful that we'll see some progress on this front if Congress is finally able to advance a comprehensive infrastructure package, hopefully as part of the economic revitalization effort we make following this pandemic. But I also know we need more innovative ideas, and we need more folks working together like all of you who are dramatically rethinking how we grow together as a region and how we build a better future. Folks who are thinking outside the box to ensure that the solutions we come up with for our communities today also work tomorrow and in the future. Folks who know that the only solutions that will work are those that don't leave anybody or any community behind. Folks that know that our transition to a climate-forward economy can't leave our frontline communities behind, and in fact, that see this as an opportunity to both mobilize our economy and create high-quality jobs in those communities. Because the only way we will succeed is if we do it together. So, to end, let me go back to where I started, and that is with saying thank you. Thanks for being part of this. Thanks for your commitment to our region, and thank you for bringing your voice, your ideas, and your advocacy to the table. Let's keep at it. Thanks, everybody.